Hey everybody, Nikki here. Welcome to December. I have your monthly tarotscope all set for you. I'm trying to dress kind of wintry today, but the truth is it's like 75 degrees outside still, and we are still waiting for winter here in Arizona. So if you have some snow or any cold weather, please send it my way because I would really, really, really love to have some of that. Okay, so we're going to do a check today to see what's going on in the areas of your three connections, right? Your connection with yourself, your connection with spirit, and your connection with your magic, right? Because these connections are very important if you're going to be walking a spiritual path. So before we get into each little area, I want to do an overall umbrella energy just to give you some extra advice or if there's anything else that we need to know this month that's overlooked in any of these other areas. So the first thing I'm getting here is I'm getting the Queen of Wands reversed, and I'm also getting the Six of Cups upright. So when I look at these, my intuition is telling me that because there's going to be a lot of giving and sharing and kindness and things that are going to be going on this month and that are going to hopefully be inspired by this month's energy. We also want to make sure that we are giving those from a good place, right? We're not doing it because we want something out of it. We're not doing it because we feel like we have to. We're not doing it to manipulate anybody or anything like that, right? It has to come from a place of just giving with a pure heart and connecting with someone with a pure heart. And sharing and giving back with a pure heart, right? That's what they're trying to tell us. And also too, it goes the reverse way also. So if you're receiving something that doesn't feel like it's coming from an authentic place or that it might be coming with strings attached, say no, right? You don't have to take anything that doesn't feel good to you, right? So I think those are both very important things to remember because that's a lot of energy that's going to be kind of coming up and being focused on this month. Now, let's take a look at what's going on in our self connection, right? What's going on in here? How are we connecting with ourselves? And what I'm getting here is I'm getting justice card, right? Balance. So the good news is we're either feeling balanced or we're going to be coming into balance this month, which I think is really important because sometimes it's difficult to find that middle ground, to find the right ingredients to make that perfect combination of something, right? Human beings are very complex individuals, and to find that combination of where we can flow and where we feel balanced with our emotions, with external forces and all of those things, it is very difficult. So it looks like you're either finding this or you're achieving it this month, which is really, really exciting. So if that's something you're looking for, you know, I think it's really important to kind of go back to your value system and see how your life is matching up with that, right? Is it in alignment with those values? And if it's not, if you can start creating more alignment for yourself in that way, you'll create more of a balance, right, for yourself and finding those right things. Now, the next thing we want to talk about is our connection with spirit, because that's really important if you're going to be here in the spiritual community. And what I see right now is you've got a lot of options going on and you're feeling a little discombobulated of which way to go. Now, this can happen for a variety of reasons. Sometimes we're just excited because there's so many new things going on and we want to try this and we want to try that. And that's never a bad thing, but also too, when you have your fingers in too many pots, it's kind of hard to focus or develop just one area. So you might want to kind of pare it down and just focus on one particular thing this month. And make sure the other thing too, what I'm seeing is, because can you see these little people here? They're going, oh my God, what does he do? Oh my God, it's too much, right? So there's might be some people watching you in your excitement or in your new training of whatever it is that you're doing. They're kind of going like this because they can see that you're not doing things properly. So whenever we get into a new subject matter or we want to try out a new practice or something like that, I'm hearing it's kind of trial and error, right? But if you are doing trial and error with a bunch of different things, you can't really master any one thing. So I think it's really good to really dive deep into the one thing that you're working on, really understand it, get the history, get the background behind it, and really know what you're doing instead of just like kind of following the top surface instructions. So I think that that's really, really important. And I'm getting the word understanding. It's more about having the understanding and learning how to apply that properly. Okay, so that's our spiritual connection this month if we're trying something new, right? Focus. Okay, so the last thing we want to really talk about is our connection with our magic. And that can be whether we're doing actual magic or it's just with our gift that we have, because every single person has a very special gift that they are meant to share with the world, and nobody else can do what they can do exactly like they can do it, right? Okay, so what I'm getting here is I'm getting the Four of Cups reverse. And to me, this card, when I'm looking at it, just intuitively, what I'm pulling off is that you need to be, they're saying you need to be open to new experiences, right, with your gift. So don't be afraid to try new things. And also too, it's about the kindness that you have behind the sharing of your gift, right? Which I think kind of goes back to that overall energy that we pulled for the spread, right? How you're sharing your, how you're sharing and giving this season. And so specifically with your gift, how it is that you're using that. And are you using it, you know, appropriately? And are you trying it out in new ways, right? I think sometimes this can be really scary. I remember too, when I first started reading tarot cards, I was terrified. I was like, oh my God, you know, I felt like I didn't know what I was doing, even though I did, because it was my gift. I was good at it just naturally. So it wasn't something I had to, you know, worry too much about. I learned the material, I practiced really hard, and it was something that I was good at, but I just didn't have that confidence yet. So if you're having an issue sharing this month, you know, the only way to be more confident and to get that validation is to share it and get that positive feedback back from other people. So don't be afraid to kind of step forward and start sharing your gift, because I guarantee you there is somebody out there that is looking for and needs specifically what you have to offer. So that's all I have for December. If you are celebrating holidays this month, I wish you a very happy holiday season. If you are not celebrating, I hope that you just have a really peaceful, relaxed, and blessed month. So until next time, thank you guys so much for watching, and have a beautiful day.